Hello everyone, SP Architects here. Today I will show you how to make parametric and modular facade design in Archicad. In this tutorial we will learn how to use walls, windows and module system, how you can benefit with module system for your designs and how you can reduce your working time in Archicad. Let's start this tutorial by creating a simple wall. From the wall tool we will change the structure to simple. I don't want to see any plaster layer onto my wall, and I can change the wall thickness, but it's okay for now. I'm just going to click the floor plan, and for the width this is going to be 4 meters. Let's hit enter, and if I hit the F3 I will see my wall created. Now let's add a window into this wall. To do this we will go to window tool. By clicking this window tool you can change its settings before placing or after placing, it's up to you. I will use the center anchor point and determine my opening direction. After that I will click this and add some reveal to wall core, something like 20, yeah, because I want to see these edges and I want the wall to be seen thick. Okay, if I hit F3 I will see this, and let's hit Ctrl plus T to go to settings. Let's change the window style. Maybe we can use this triple. It's not symmetrical. Let's make this symmetrical. In the settings we will see this shape. This is not asymmetric. Now we click this symmetric, it's okay. Let's increase this value to 50. Maybe this is the preview. It's okay. You can change the materials under the parameter model attributes under the frame and sesh. Let's click this uniform and make this something gray. I like dark gray. I want to reduce the frame thickness. I will go back and you can see this 13 is different than others. So if we click this uniform frame width, it will equal with others as 5. Let's click OK. Way more better. We will change this number as before. Yeah. There we go. Let's add some design for this wall. Let's go to ground floor. Let's add a slab. Structure to simple. And maybe 150 will be okay. Another wall here and also here. Let's add a triangle shape just like this and intersect. But it's not okay because we need some front elements to do this. First we will need to change the wall thickness and make another wall like this. And now we can create a symmetry from the middle. Let's select the walls, right click to here, opening, click move, and let's select this mirror a copy like this. Now we will have this one. I presume that this is going to be a balcony, maybe a sliding door. In this stage you can change this window to a sliding door, but you can also change the width of the window to turn this into a sliding. After that this is opening. If we go to settings from here, yeah. Let's make this 70. Yeah, okay. And now we can use this. I want to change the material like maybe gray. Let's make this light gray or stone granite gray. For the override surface for the top, let's make this wood. and same with the stone. Let's click OK. Not too bad. Let's select all of the walls and give some same materials. It was stone, granite gray, also this. It's not okay. I think we can override this as well. Stone granite gray. There we go. I want to change this white part of the wall. I want this to be a white color. You can see this blue reference line. This blue reference line is outside. Therefore, we need to change the inside. I think if we hover over this, we can see this inside. Yeah. Input white. Click OK. And now it's okay. Okay, now we will turn this into a modular system and see what we are going to have. Let's select this object and we will go to File. We will go to External Content and click Save Selection as Module. Here we are in the saving window. We will create this replace selection with Hotlink Module and let's type here Wall 1. If you go to options, you will see you can change the current base file if you want to reduce your file size. It's okay for now and click OK. Now we are in the 3D window and if you can click this, you will see the corners are different. They are not pointed, they're small triangles, small rectangles. That seems this is a kind of module system. And if you click the suspend group, you can select them, but you cannot move. You cannot move. If you want to move this object, you need to click suspend groups off and you need to move all of the hotlink module like this. If you want to change something in the module file, I will show you how to do it soon. For now, I'm going to select all of them. And I'm going to copy this like this, or I can hit Ctrl plus U and click this increment and spread. And I can make something like this. Let's add another floor plan, floor actually. By clicking insert above, the height to next is same. And after that, I will select them, hit Ctrl plus U again, click elevate, set home story by elevation. For this time, you can use this increment and spread, or you can just input your spacing value directly. We know our height to next level is 3 meters, 300 centimeters. We can type in here. Let's click OK and click somewhere here and elevate. There we go. As you can see, we have created this with only one click. Now I want to show you module system magic. I'm going to select any of these, right click, and after that I will go to Hotlink module. I will click this, edit module system in separate Archicad. Let's click this. Alright, here we are in new section of Archicad. As you can see, the file name is wall1 because this is the module system name, and this is our floor plan object. Now we will change this with this Archicad file. For instance, I'm going to add a railing, maybe from the floor. I want to sketch it first. Something like this, maybe from center. I will make it symmetry, go to railing, and if I go to settings for the railing settings, we have some favorite. Let's use this frameless glass railing. Let's double click that. For the segment, it's okay, we have some inner post, that's okay. Okay, hit the space. And no, I will go back. I will click one by one, here, 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 and the last. In the window, we have this one, but I want to change the home story to ground floor. That's okay. Maybe if I go to segments, I can see different options such as this timber fencing segment, but I'm not going to use that. I want to click the panel actually, and I want to get rid of this frame and fixing. Just like this. Way more better. And as you can see, this railing, handrail, is round or circular. I will turn this into a rectangle shape. From here, I will click this top rail, click this rectangle, and click OK. This center part is not OK. We can fix it by going to segment and clicking this icon. Just like this. In order to update this into our original floor plan, we will go to floor plan. Actually, we cannot save it in the 3D because this is a module system. Now we can save this. Go to file and click save. Now it was saved. Let's go back to main file. We will select enough module, but just be sure suspend group will be off. Right click, hot link module, and click update module and all related hot links. And you will see all of the objects are updated. To see this better, I will right click this 3D, go to 3D styles, and click white model with shadows. There we go. This was how you can create parametric modular system facade in Archicad. If you like this tutorial, you can just hit the like button and do not forget to subscribe if you want to see more tutorials like this. Also, like button is very important for me because I will understand this kind of tutorial will be liked for you, and I'm going to make similar tutorial like this. Thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day. Bye. And if you are serious about learning Archicad, you can go to my Patreon page. From there, I will be waiting for you. Alright, thank you for watching. Until next time, have a nice day. Bye.